Well, I'm back again. Now, this part of the exercise, you're going to learn how to use bending tools. The spring bender and the tube bender. Understand that copper is very expensive. It's almost $3 a pound, if not more. So, just as you did before, you will ask the instructor or staff for a piece of copper, and they'll hand that to you. All right? Remember, when you're done using this copper, you can cut it up in smaller pieces to use for further projects, okay? So just like everything else here, you gotta have your gloves and your safety gear, long sleeve shirt, closed toes, no shorts. All right, you've signed out your toolkit, you pull out your tape measure, your black pen, that's about all you really need for right now, as well as your 3/8 bender and your 1/2 inch bender. All right, now common sense is going to tell you, if you don't know, just put the pipe in there and test it and you'll figure out which one's which. There's no markings on this. All right, and then you're going to also use the small black hand bender. Now that hand bender is inside this red toolbox. This red toolbox is up underneath the shelf, all right? All I ask is that you put it back and use care with it. Then you're gonna get two pieces of copper. One piece is 3/8, the other one's the 1/2 inch. It's already been cut for you, and it's gonna turn out something like this, all right? Nothing drastic. All we're gonna try to do is show you how to use the tool correctly. That's it. All right? So, let's just start with a small piece of copper. All right? And the reason we're going to use this is it's flexible, it's soft, and when we're done, we're going to try to bend it back so we can use it in the tube bender. All right? So here I go. I don't know what size it is. I'm checking it. Now you can see that it fits in there, all right? I don't have to shove it down in there, it fits. So the first thing that I wanna do, put my glasses on and open up my tape measure so that I can basically take off 2 inches. Mark 2 inches and then mark 7 inches from that, which would make that 9 inches. Or if you want, just move the tape measure to 7. All right. Now, my points are marked. All right. Now, I did that because I'm going to first bend my 45 and then my 90. But then I'm going to flatten it back out for the tube bender. The marking is on there already, so I don't have to deal with that if the pipe doesn't come out exactly straight. But remember, I told you, what you want to do with this pipe is you want to bend it at a 45-degree angle. Now, even though this is a spring bender, you can't just go like that. It isn't going to happen. You got to needle it, all right? Play with it and work it down. Soft copper bends pretty smoothly. But let me show you, you don't have to have a lot of upper body strength until you get into that 7/8 stuff, and then, you know, you wish you had a tube bender. All right, so let's just say we set it in there, and I'm just kind of eyeballing the center point. It doesn't have to be anything drastic, all right? But here, if this is my center point, I want to start a couple inches below. And just, you see how natural and slow I'm taking this? And I work it around. All right? And I just keep going back and forth. All right? And what I'm trying to do is get a 45. Now, you don't have to get a measuring tool out and everything else. I'm trying to get you to understand how to use the tool. So I think that needs to be bent a little bit more, but I just come back and slowly kneel it until I think I've got a 45-degree angle. All right, I can pull that out, and there's my 45. All right, you show that to the instructor or staff, and they'll tell you to move on, which is going to be using to do your 90. Okay, put it back in the sleeve. All right, and again, kneel it. Now, it may take a little longer, but take your time. All right, you cannot be in a rush, because once you kink this, it's over. All right, so there's my 90 basically. And what we're looking for at the 90, and remember, if this looks like it's off a little bit, so what? Put it back in, twist it the other way. It's easy if you just take your time. But what's important is, you notice right here, it's very smooth on both top and bottom, on the inside and outside. There's no kinks. If you have a kink, you got to do it again. But don't throw away the copper. Just use it on a different project. All right? So, that's 3/8. Half inch, done exactly the same. All right, check your tubing and then bend it. All right? So now I want to straighten this out. Well, all you have to do with soft copper is just gently fold it back down. All right, you don't have to have it completely straight. Okay? That's the beauty about this stuff. All right? It's like working with Play-Doh. You know, you make a mistake, you might be able to correct it. Okay, so here we are. Our marks are still in place, and we're ready to go. Now we've done both the half inch and the 3/8 tubing, so you can put that back in your toolbox. Now what we're going to do is we're going to hopefully use the tool, the tool bender, all right, the tubing bender, and make something like this. Now, not everybody's is going to come out exactly the same, because the pipes might be cut a little different. Don't lose sleep over that. If you notice, the tool, if you put it together, looks like this. You have the zero and the zero lined up. You have an R and you have an L. Right, left. But I'm not getting involved in all that. We are just trying to learn how to use a tool at the very basics. All right? You have this little catch piece that's going to hold your copper in place. The handle lifts up so that you can slide your copper tubing into it. All right? Now, there is only one slot for 3/8. All right? Don't put it in the 1/8 inch or the quarter, because it will destroy the copper. All right? Now you notice where my black line is, all right, versus my line for my zero. It's almost lined up perfectly. Now you may have to tweak it a little bit, okay? But you notice how it all comes together, okay? Now the trick to this is constantly keep pressure on it. Because what you're going to do is you're going to bend to 90 degrees first. All right? And all you have to do is push down until that mark reads 90. All right? Now we're going to continue on, so don't let pressure up on it. Now we're going to go and take 180 degrees. Okay? There's the 180. All right. Release it. Jar it loose a little bit. You may have to just kind of wiggle it around. That's okay. All right. And there's our first curve. Again, we're looking to be sure that there's no concave tweaking, stretching of the copper. All right. Now we're going to go to our other line, which is right here. That was that 7-inch line. Okay, but this time we're going to reverse the curl, the 180. So we get our tool set up. All right, now we're going to put our copper back in there, but remember, I want to line it up first, okay, and bring down my head on that. All right, but what's wrong with this picture, you ask? Well, if I bend it the way it is, then I make a complete loop, and I don't want that. So what you want to do is you want to rotate it 180 degrees. All right, keep everything nice and tight and snug, double check everything, make sure everything's lined up, and then make your 90, and then make your 180. You may have to get your hands out of the way. All right, there, I overdid a little bit, but hey, it isn't, the world isn't gonna end here. All right. If it does that, just pull it out. All right. Then, if it isn't flat, make it flat, okay? All you have to do is tweak it a little bit. Don't go over nuts on it, okay? There. All right, now you notice that there's a difference, all right, in size. All I did was cut back on the copper for demonstration purposes, but it's the same bend. And you understand that what we're looking for is the curvature is nice and smooth. There's no tweaks, there's no bending in it, all right, as far as crimps in the copper. It's a smooth flow, because if you interrupt the flow of water or refrigerant, it's going to cause problems with it. So therefore, we're done with the project. Now, you could probably save this little piece. I'd appreciate it if you can, and all you have to do is just bend it out a little bit, use your tube cutter, cut it off and save it. All right, and there'll be a box for stuff like that. The rest of this can go in the trash can. All right. Now, that's with the 3/8. Now, I told you that it was in the red box. It says Turbo Torch kit and hand benders. Now, in here, you will also find another tube bender, along with the instructions on how to use this. All right. Please pay attention. If you forget, go out, come out here and read the instructions. If you notice, it looks almost identical to the other one. The only major difference is right here. You'll see where this little red slot or knob moves. Moves your device up to different lengths or different widths, depending on what you're trying to use. All right, so we're at half inch, so we need to have that screw, and try not to move it out so that you drop the screw. All right, but you'll notice it's written there, half inch, all right, 3/8 and a quarter. All right, so that allows you to do almost any type of your standard piping. Now, again, we're not making anybody an expert. You don't have to jerk down on this really tight. Just firm it up, all right? But again, you notice that it works the same way. Nothing really is that difficult about this. Mark off your copper tubing. Remember, now you're going to do the 45 first, then the half inch, or the 90, excuse me. You do the 45, the 90, and then straighten it back out. And your marks are already there at 2 inch and at 7 inches. All right? So remember, 2 inch plus 7 inches. All right. Once that's marked, then you can do your 45 in your spring bender, your 90 in the spring bender, pull it out, lay it out, get it as flat as you can, and then use the tube bender. All right. No difference in this tool. All right. If my mark was right there, then I just set it down, line up my zeros, and go to it. All right. Hopefully there's no questions. How often are you going to use this in the field? Not often, but you know, when you're going through attics or you need to make a nice smooth turn, those, because you want to make it look professional. You don't want to do something, you know, half cocked there. All right. But be sure all the tools get back. The instructors check this out and make sure that it meets the criteria, and then you can move on to your next task. Please remember, safety is our utmost goal here. Saving the copper so we can use it on other items is phenomenal. We have to do that, and I appreciate all the help that you do. Be sure your toolboxes are in good shape. If they're not, let me know or an instructor. All right. I think that'll do it. If you have any questions, get with first. If you get out here and you're confused, go back and watch the video. Then if you don't understand something, come out here and ask one of us and we'll get you started. All right. You have to pay attention to what's going on around here. All right. You will be required to do this out in the field. And we want to be sure that you're trained up correctly. Thank you. Do, 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 do.